Hello, hello.
Hello, hello.
Dear Manhattans, welcome to our 20th episode. And before we begin and Savika gives us our clarion call, I want us to remember a website. It's called www.covid-relief.in. I repeat, www.covid-relief.in. In this website, you'll find all the list of organizations and even animal shelters and independent initiatives which have taken a lead in helping the hunger crisis and the crisis that looms at large on our country right now because of the COVID-19 lockdown.
All right, and with that, let's take our clap on the count of 3, 2, 1. Action.
Savika, aaj main soch rahi thi. We have engaged with creating the Mad Heart Talks. And within the Mad Heart Talks, you have helped us create a museum where we have brought in all the novelty items of this times of quarantine, thanks to novel coronavirus. But where is safe space? Where is home? And to those of us who have just joined us, our new subscribers, our new viewers, big shout out to you. Hi, this is Priya and Savika, or PS, as we call ourselves. And we are basically two friends trying to cope up with the apocalypse by building this e-bunker called the Mad Heart Talks. And today I want to ask Savika about safe space.
It's interesting that I've always gone back the minute the word safe space comes up. I've always found it very fascinating ki bachpan mein hum jab ghar ghar khelte the, so the house wasn't enough. Corners were where safe spaces were found, or essentially spaces where you could play ghar ghar or felt at home in some sense. Like, I think even as children, we sought corners for some reason. Corners or shelves or, you know, like...
Tables ke andar.
Haan, table ke andar. Like, khopche kehlo. Kya kahenge? So yeah, I think off the top of my head, the most childlike instinct is to seek corners. Yes, even when earthquakes happen, you seek corners.
That is true. Which actually straight away reminds me of the earthquake that shook us on 15th of December, when Jamia students got attacked in India. And why we bring this up today is because, I'm sorry, we can no longer ignore that our country is suffering because of more reasons than COVID-19 crisis. We were in the middle of socio-political upheaval when the lockdown began. And yesterday, the news broke for a journalist, a 26-year-old lady, in fact, called Masrat Zahara, has been booked under the UAPA Act, which is also called the, you know, Unlawful Activities Prevention Act. And, you know, Savika, her crime was just to tell her own story in her own words, just like you and me are trying to do.
I think before we started recording this, I was very curious about, is talking about sedition also seditious? Do you think that because of this episode, we might get into trouble? I mean, it's quite interesting, honestly, कि आप कितनी छोटी-छोटी चीजों को करने से पहले ये सोचते भी नहीं है कि आपको बांध ही लेना चाहिए था सर पे कफन. मतलब might as well prepare for the worst. Anyway, so continuing that line of thought, I do think that it's quite interesting that we're talking about safe space in this context, especially with my surname being Muzaffar, because I think अंदर से आता है तो अलग बात होती है, लेकिन जब आपको कोई भी एक्सटर्नली रिमाइंड करता है कुछ भी कि मैं बार बार प्रिया तुमको रिमाइंड करती रहूँ तुम औरत हो तुम अपनी जगह समझो, आई मीन इवन दैट वुड पिंच इन द सेम वे एज यू नो नॉट फाइंडिंग अ हाउस इन अ सिटी लाइक बॉम्बे बिकॉज योर सरनेम इज मुजफ्फर. और यू नो ऑल्सो इंटरेस्टिंगली गेटिंग कॉल्स फ्रॉम ऑल सॉर्ट्स ऑफ पीपल सेइंग दैट I wish I could offer empathy, but I don't know if I can even claim to understand what kind of a situation you're in. And in that sense, at least for someone like me, I felt othered at so many levels that firstly, I felt othered by my own community because maybe I have othered my community from the beginning. Matlab, I've never really worn my religion on my sleeve, and therefore I've never really understood ki agar koi sirf mere surname ke basis pe mujhko judge kar raha hai, to matlab, it almost feels like ki tumne saalon mehnat ki and you know, it doesn't really count. Kyunki ghar to tumko nahi milega. Kyunki just because you have that surname, and that surname is not featuring on XYZ's rental lease for sure. So I don't know, like it's interesting that when we were shifting from my Ghargaon to Gurgaon, I realized for the first time ki maine bahut shehar shift kiye hain. I've never moved out of the country. Maine bahut is mulk, is vatan ke bahut kamron mein bahut jaan ji hai, kaafi jaan chhidki hai. But when the 15th December attacks happened, we were a week away from the biggest move of my life. And for the first time, I was like, maybe every house is a refugee camp now. Like, what's the point? Like, where are you safe anymore? To the extent that on the 15th December night, I was performing somewhere and someone asked me, are you safe? Did you two, like I was with my sister, did you two reach home safely? I was like, I'm sorry, but does that question even count anymore? Am I safe in this house anymore? When no house is home, when the country itself isn't home. So then, is the question, are you safe? Did you reach home safely? What does it even mean?
I also, obviously, with a surname like mine, Priya Goswami, cannot have, I can only offer empathy. I can't offer anything but empathy, actually. But a quick refresher for our viewers, it pinched me, and it pinched me how? When my dear best friend called me one day and said that, you know, she did not get an apartment in the most cosmopolitan city in the country on the basis of her surname. It enraged me. Because I have not known anyone more secular than Sabika. I might not know the Ramzan dates, but Sabika will be celebrating Holi Diwali with the best way she can. She might even know the Gayatri Mantra and, you know, do puja part, which I have never done. This is not a question of proving your religious allegiance through the practices you know or you don't know. But yes, in times like these, when all of us are feeling homeless within our homes, all you can do is offer empathy to those people who may already be feeling homeless within their homes, their country, because their country doesn't believe that they belong to the country. And with that, I just want to have one unified message from Sabika and me. Please free Masrat Zahara. And if you can't do anything about it, please do render your voice to freeing a 26-year-old Kashmiri photojournalist whose only crime was to take to the camera, find or try to find her safe space with her own lens and tell her own story in her own words. If you enjoy Sabika and my videos, you know we are just two women trying to claim our own voice in our own words through this channel. Everyone should have a little bit sky above their heads, and they should be allowed that sky.
Or an e-bunker, which allows you to see the sky through a glass roof. Yes. On that note, let's offer some homely love. All right. 3, 2, 1.
Yes, love. Love you.